What's up, guys? Welcome to the very first episode of Film Tips Plus, where we talk about film tips plus a little extra. On this very first episode, we're talking about buying your filmmaking gear from pawn shops. All of the things you see on screen right now are actually all the things that I bought at my local pawn shops around this area in the last couple of years. Alright, so let's get into the things you will need to know before buying your gear from pawn shops. First things first, they are a business. They are there to take your money and make money. So, like everything else, be prepared to spend a little bit. Second, they are willing to negotiate, most of the time. Especially if an item's been on the shelf for a long time, they'll be willing to go down on it. Third, be willing to wait on an item. If you come into the store and see a lens for sale, or a microphone for example, there's a really good chance that it'll still be there for about a week or two. You go talk to them, they don't want to budge on a price, just leave. Come back a couple of weeks, couple of days later, and they will be willing to budget the price a little more. For example, my 11-20 Tokina lens, I went into the pawn shop, saw the lens, saw the price. The guy did not want to budge. I believe he was listing it for about $270. And so I left. I came back, the lens was still there, nobody buys it. Film stuff, like I say, moves pretty slow at pawn shops. And I got the lens for $200 plus tax. Tip number four goes right along with the last one, which is don't get too attached to items. Tip number five is for prices. For this one, always bring your phone in with you because you always want to check the listings on eBay and other things, see if you can find an item cheaper anywhere else. One thing you may have to watch out for with pawn shops is a lot of times they don't actually know what they're selling. And so sometimes the prices will be way lower or way higher than they should be. First thing you should know, all the stuff is always going to be used. So I would always suggest bringing your camera and an audio recorder such as the Zoom H4n in case you want to test out a lens, see if it works, or a microphone, see if it functions correctly, see if there's anything wrong with it. I also never really set out to look for something in particular because I know that I'll never really find exactly what I'm looking for, so I just look around and see all the deals they have. For example, the microphones that I've bought, I still haven't used them that much. I've used them on some voiceover work, and I will use them for a podcast in the future, but they weren't what I was in the market for at the moment. However, I couldn't pass up the really good deal. So if you have a day off, just take a stroll around your local pawn shops, take a look. Maybe you'll also find a really good deal on some of your new favorite filmmaking gear. And with that, this episode of Film Tips Plus is coming to a close. Thank you so much for watching. And in the comments down below, let me know your experiences with shopping for film gear or other items at pawn shops. Let me know if you found some good deals or anything like that. I would really like to know. The next video on this channel will be the short film I put out on Friday, followed by the commentary on Monday, and I will see you on Film Tips Plus in 2 weeks. Thanks for watching, and good night.